Hi guys, hope you're all doing fine. Welcome back to another video. In this video, we will be looking at another lead code problem named as longest palindromic substring, which states that given a string S, find the longest palindromic substring in S. You may assume that the maximum length of S is 1000. Two examples are given here. The first example, S is BABAD. Here, the palindromes are BAB and ABA. Among these, we can either select BAB or ABA as the longest palindromic substring. In example 2, the input is CBBD and the longest palindromic substring is BB. Palindromes can be either even or odd, as we have seen in both the examples. So let us consider an example string ABCBAD. The possible palindromic substring for this example are A, B, C, B, C, B, A, B, C, B, A, and D. We can also consider single characters as odd length palindromes of length 1. That's why we also considered the single characters A, B, C, and D into our list. Here, we can see that the palindrome A, B, C, B, A is the longest palindromic substring for an example. So, in order to solve this problem, we can use Mannekes algorithm, which is a well-known algorithm to solve this particular problem. In this algorithm, we create an array T to store the string ABCBAD as shown in the slide. And we also create another array P to store palindrome count at every character of T. At the beginning, we initialize the array P to 0. So, Mannekes algorithm begins as follows. Initially, we declare three integer variables C to 1, which is the center, R to 1, which is right boundary, and the variable max length to 0, which is the length of the longest palindromic substring. Later, we traverse the characters of a string one by one, and at each traversal, we find the mirror position of a character, and after that, we perform the following operations. So, let's begin by traversing the first element. So, I points to 1, the value of C and R are 1. So, we calculate the mirror element by using the following formula, which is 2c minus I. So, we get the value of mirror as 1. So, the element as well as the mirror of the element lies at the same location. So, we proceed further and check whether the value of I is less than R. It is not. So, we skip the part and we also check whether the left side and the right side of our ith location are equal or not. Since both the characters are not equal, we proceed further and check whether the value of P of I is greater than max length. Since it is not greater, we still proceed further and increment the value of I. So now I points to the second location and the value of C and R are as in the previous iteration. So now we calculate the mirror location as 2c minus I, which is 0, and then we compare whether I is less than R, which is not. Now we also compare the left side and right side of a ith location. Since both these characters are equal, we increment the value of P of I. So, the value of P of I becomes 1. We check further whether dollar and B are equal. Since they are not, we break out of the while loop and check whether the value of P of I is greater than max length. Yes, it is. So, we update the value of max length as P of I.
So now the value of max length become 1. And finally, we check whether I plus P of I is greater than R. The value of I is 2 and the value of P of I is 1. Since 2 plus 1 is greater than R, therefore, we update the value of C to 2 and the value of R to 3 and increment I. So now I points to the third location and the mirror of I is at location 1. So we again check the left side and right side of our ith location. Since these two characters are not equal, we proceed further and increment the value of I. Now I points to the fourth location. And again, we calculate the mirror location, which points to 0, and check the left and right side of ith location. Since these two values are equal, we increment the value of P of I. Again, we check whether the values at index 2 and 6 are equal. Since they are not equal, we break out of the while loop and check whether the value of P of I is greater than max length. Since it is not, we move further and check whether the value of I plus P of I is greater than R. Since it is, so we update the values of C to 4 and R to 5 and increment I. Now I points to the fifth location. The mirror of I is at location 3 and we check the left and right locations of ith position. Since both these characters are unequal, we proceed further and increment the value of I to point index 6. The mirror is at index 2. Now we again check the left and right of the ith location. Since these two characters are equal, we proceed further with increment the value of P of I. Even the elements at position 4 and 8 are equal, we again increment the value of P of I and proceed further. Now these two characters are also equal, so the value of P of I will increment again. It keeps on incrementing until we find an unequal pair of characters. So now we can see that the characters at position 0 and 12 are unequal. That's why we can break off the while loop and check that the value of P of I is greater than max length. Since the value of P of I is 5 and the value of max length is 1, therefore we update the value of max length as 5. And also update the value of C and R to 6 and 11 because of the following if condition, where we check that I plus P of I is greater than R. Now we increment the value of I to point to 7th location. The mirror here is the value at 5th location. Now we check the left and right positions. Since these two are unequal, we proceed further. And we perform the similar steps for each character from the 8th position onwards, and we get the following results. So after completely traversing a string, we get the values of P as follows. So now we know that the value of max length is 5. We can directly return this value if we want the length of longest palindromic substring. Since in our case we don't want the length of longest palindromic substring, but we want the first occurrence of the longest palindromic substring. In that case, we can traverse an array P to check the first occurrence of the longest palindromic substring. For that case, we can traverse the array P and check the value of P of I with that of max length. Since the values are unequal, we can keep on traversing until we find the same value. Since we found the value which is equal to the value of max length, therefore we can stop here and we got a longest parent roaming substring by moving ahead and backward 5 steps from the character C, that is from this hash to this hash. Therefore, a longest palindromic substring is ABCBA.
So finally, we can begin with our code. Initially, we need to store the string length in a variable called length, and we need to check whether the string is a single character or not. If it is a single character, we can directly return the string. Else, we can proceed further with our code. As we have seen in the explanation part, we need to create another array T to store the string as follows. For the string ABCBAD, we store it as a new string in which the first character is dollar and the last character is @ symbol. In between, we have many hashes. So the starting of the array contains a dollar followed by hash character. So we can create a vector to store the new string. As we have seen, the first two characters are dollar and hash. So we have pushed these two characters into the vector. After that, we declare few variables. N is equal to 2. N is the size of the vector T. Now the size is 2, so we initialize N to 2. As we have seen in the explanation part, we initialize 3 variables, namely C, R and max length. C21, R21, and max length to 0. Now we keep on adding the original characters with the hash symbol to a new string. As we have already pushed the hash character to a new string, we first push a character and then the hash character. And we keep on incrementing the value of n by 2. And finally, we push the @ symbol to a vector. And increment the value of n. As we have seen in the explanation part, along with the array T, we also create another array P to store the palindrome count at every character of T. For that sake, we create an array of integers, namely P, whose size is equal to same as that of T, and we initialize it with 0. So now we begin with the actual code, which is Manakkar's algorithm's code. We traverse the array T from the first character to the last character. Excluding the dollar and @ character, which are the first and last characters of a new string. That's why we started the loop from I is equal to 1 up till I is equal to I is less than n minus 1. The first step which we do is find the mirror location, which can be found out using the formula 2c minus i. Then we check whether I is less than r. If so, then we update the value of p of I as minimum of r minus I and p of mirror. And then we check how many of the left and right characters are equal, and based on that condition, we increment the value of p of I. Here, we keep on checking whether the left and right location of the ith character are equal or not. If they are equal, then we increment the value of p of I. And we keep on incrementing until we find an unequal pair of characters. So, we update the value of max length if the value of p of I is greater than max length. And finally, we update the value of C and R if the following condition holds, which is if I plus P of I is greater than R, that is, if a character excludes the right boundary, in that case, we update the value of C to I and R to I plus P of I. And we have done with the half part of our code, where we get the value of max length. We can proceed further with a remaining half of the code, where we traverse the array P and we check whether any of the character is equal to the value of max length. If so, we calculate the starting position of our longest palindromic substring and break out of the loop. We can declare an integer variable L to store the starting of a longest palindromic substring and start traversing the array P. At each traversal, we check whether P of I is equal to max length. If so, we calculate the value of L and break out of the loop. As we have seen in the beginning of the video, palindrome can either be even length or odd length. For both the cases, we calculate the value of L accordingly. So in case a palindrome is odd length, then the value of L is calculated as, first, we remove the first and last character, which are the dollar and at the rate character. That's why we entered I minus 2, and then we divide by 2. Since we have entered the hash symbols in between, therefore, to get our original string, we apply the following formula. And after that, by subtracting this value from max length by 2 minus 1, we get a value of L. And similarly, in case of even length palindromes. So, after we get the value of L, we store a longest palindromic substring in a variable called out. Here we can use the substr function, which is available in the string str library, where the arguments are the starting index and the length. And finally, we return the variable out, which is the longest palindromic substring. And a code is finished. We can run a code to check whether it contains any errors or warnings. So a code runs fine without any errors or warning. So we can proceed further and submit a code. So finally, a code got submitted successfully. So if you found this video helpful and had a brief understanding of Manakkas algorithm, do hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more such upcoming videos. Thank you.